Studies show that tweets with images get more interaction, more engagement, and more clicks. So it's really cool that Buffer came out with this new tool called Pablo that's going to help you get images in your tweets. Stay right there and I'll introduce you to Pablo. First, let's head over to Twitter just so you can take a look at how it looks when we share images and how they tend to stand out in the Twitter stream. I also notice that I get a little bit more engagement most of the time when I'm sharing an image. I'll get favorites. I'll get retweets. Here's one where I'm getting retweets and favorites. And the numbers are usually higher than when I don't include an image. And these are just my results. Of course, your mileage may vary, but even for people who are using Hootsuite, and Hootsuite is what I use most of the time to monitor my Twitter streams, and you'll see that even when you're monitoring your Twitter stream through Hootsuite, the images tend to stand out and get your attention. Before we start talking about Pablo, I have to mention that you need to have an account with Buffer. If you don't have an account with Buffer already, it's okay. I've done a video about that before, and it's easy to use. You just need to sign up with one of your social accounts like Twitter or Facebook. And you can also sign in with your email address. Now we can head over into Pablo. And Pablo is really awesome, and it's an online tool that you'll use. And for the most part, you want to make quote graphics. And what I mean by a quote graphic is you put a beautiful image behind some famous quote. Okay, that's one of the primary uses. So now this is how it works. When you log in, there'll already be a preloaded quote there. If you don't like that quote, you easily change it right here just by clicking that little arrow, and it'll scroll through different quotes. If you don't like the position of it, you can change the position. You can also change the font. You can change the color of the font. The choices are limited though to white, black, blue, and red. There's a couple of other things you can do too. You can increase the size of the font. You can change the styling of the fonts. In other words, you can make it italic, or you can make it light, or you can make it bold. You can add a secondary line of text if you want. A lot of times I like to add my handle there. You can also add an icon. So if you wanted to add your logo, you can just position that wherever you want. And if you wanted to make that logo a little bit bigger or smaller, you can change the size of it as well. Now, the next thing I want to bring to your attention is that you can adjust the image qualities. You can do normal, blurred, black and white, and this increased contrast. I noticed that a lot of times that's already on by default, and usually that works with a normal. Most of the time I don't use the increased contrast, and unless that works well with a specific quote or the image that you're using. Now in this case, let's try a different image because that one's not working too well when I have the increased contrast turned off. So let's try something different. Here are some of the choices of images. And you move over to the right and you can see there's a bunch of them in here. And you don't have to worry about having permission to use them. Buffer has taken care of all of that. But one of my fave things about this tool is that we can also upload our own image. And I have a library of images that I've got from royalty-free image sharing sites. And we can upload our own images. And I think this is absolutely marvelous because then I can change this text to whatever I want it to be. For example, let's say I wanted to promote one of my blog posts. I can simply upload my blog post image. Here, I'll use this one. And then I'll just make sure that image is in the right position, so none of the important bits get cut off. Then I'll just delete whatever text was in there. But this way, I have a perfectly sized image that I can use on Twitter or also could share it on Facebook. But what I would do is actually download that image. Okay, so just so you know, if I wanted to, I could buffer my image right from here. That means it will add it to my queue on Buffer. One last thing before I go, I want to give my random shout out of the week. And this one goes to my friend Elizabeth Hall from over at Smart Office Help. She has a dynamite YouTube channel as well as a blog and a podcast. I mean, Elizabeth is really doing the thing. So check out Elizabeth Hall. I will definitely link to her channel here. And once again, I'm so glad you had a chance to come over and learn how to use Pablo. Once again, it's Ileane from Basic Blog Tips. Please be sure to subscribe to my channel because I have more exciting videos coming for you real soon. Take care. Peace.